Hi, and welcome to this lecture on the topology of aircraft and spacecraft structures. When you sit in an aircraft, or if you're very lucky, a spacecraft, it feels as if you're inside a thick tube. However, all is not quite as it seems. Let me show you. If you look at the photo of the cockpit on the left, it appears as if the aircraft wall is quite thick. However, if you strip away all the equipment, you can see that the actual skeleton of the aircraft is really quite slender and thin. What you can see in the second photo here is what we call an airframe. That is an aircraft or spacecraft without installed equipment and furnishings, just its bare structural skin and bones. So what are the main functions on an airframe? They're threefold. First of all, they have a load-bearing function. The airframe takes up the forces during flight, takeoff and landing, and when making maneuvers. Secondly, the skin and framework, which you could see as a skeleton, also provides the aerodynamic shape needed to generate lift. And finally, at least nowadays, the airframe provides those inside with the protection from the environment. This was of course not always the case. If we look at this drawing of the first Dutch aircraft to fly, the Fokker Spin or Spider, you can see that sheltering pilots from the environment wasn't exactly a priority in the early days of flying. But things have come a long way since then. If we look at the F-16 Fighting Falcon, we can see that the pilot is fully encased. Sometimes it is difficult to say whether an item is part of the airframe or not. Let's take a look at the space shuttle. Do the ceramic tiles that protect the occupants from the heat at re-entry belong to the airframe or not? You could argue yes, as they shield the astronauts. However, they have no load-bearing function, so based on that criterion, they're not part of the airframe. When we look at the airframe, we can divide the airframe into primary and secondary structures. The primary structure of an aircraft is formed by those parts of the aircraft or spacecraft that in case of severe damage will cause the entire aircraft to fail. Think here of the fuselage, the wing, or the empennage, that is the tail of the aircraft, consisting of a horizontal and vertical tailplane. Secondary structures are elements of aircraft or spacecraft that carry only aerodynamic or inertia loads, generated on or in the secondary structure. Here, you can think of the wing-to-body fairings, the dorsal fins that serve purely aerodynamic purposes. The same argument applies to the radome and in certain cases the winglets. To decide if a structure is a primary or secondary structure, it is important that you carry out a risk assessment of the consequences of the structure failing to come to your decision. To create this airframe or skeleton, it is built up out of a number of structural elements. These have their own names, and as we'll be using these terms a lot, it is important that you familiarize yourself with the terminology. Let me start with the topology of an aircraft fuselage. It generally consists of the skin, which forms the outside of the fuselage. This is reinforced on the inside with frames. They are the circular arches you can see. Its longitudinal shape is capped by stringers. Those are the thin parallel beams in between the frames. To ensure the aircraft can be pressurized, a fuselage also has to house bulkheads, which is the solid frame here just below the cockpit windows. Finally, there are the splices, which are the connections that perform the total load transfer between two structural elements. The topology of a wing consists of the wing skin panels, forming the outer shape. The ribs that maintain the aerodynamic shape and that can be used to introduce loads into the wing. The spar that keeps the wing from bending. And finally, the assembly of spars and skin that together form a coherent roll that resists the torsion or twisting of the wing. Hopefully, this will give you some basic understanding of how an aircraft or spacecraft structure is built up.